Hello friends, in this session we will discuss non-cooperation movement. The non-cooperation movement is important historical event in India, and this non-cooperation movement was launched on 1st August 1920. In this session we will discuss the background of non-cooperation movement, the causes of non-cooperation movement, the outcome, and what was the real intention of this movement. Actually, in 1920, on 1st August, Father of Nation M.K. Gandhi launched this non-cooperation movement. Soon after Jallianwala massacre, 1919, Gandhi decided to launch non-cooperation movement in a non-violent way. The aim of this movement was to resist British rule in India through non-violent means, or you can say satyagraha. Satyagraha, or you can say non-violent way, was the theme of this non-cooperation movement. That means there was no place for violence in this non-cooperation movement. However, during discussion you will come to know that this non-cooperation movement was suspended by Gandhi due to violence in Chauri Chaura incidents in 1922. Let's discuss step by step of this non-cooperation movement. First of all, let's discuss the cause of this non-cooperation movement. The first cause is, after, you can say, First World War, after First World War, or you can say point is disillusion at the end of the First World War, there were some Indians who did not want to cooperate with the government during the war. But Gandhiji thought it's improper to take advantage of weak position of rulers. With the outbreak of First World War, India came to be involved in the war as a part of British Empire. However, the British government utilized India's wealth, manpower, money, everything for their own interest. But after Second World War, they did not cooperate. The second point is Home Rule Movement. Indians were disappointed to see British government adopting repressive measure. In response to it, Tilak and Annie Besant started Home Rule Movement. That means Home Rule Movement, which was started in 1917, also part of this cause, or you can say cause of this non-cooperation movement. First is disillusion at the end of First World War. Second is Home Rule Movement. And in this Home Rule Movement, Lucknow Pact had brought Congress and Muslim League together. And extremists to the Congress gave a militant character. The Home Rule Movement prepared the ground for non-cooperation movement. So first point is end of First World War ended the hope and aspiration of Indians who participated in First World War, because British will give freedom, British will give facilities to Indians, but British denied that. Second cause is Home Rule Movement. And third cause is the economic distress caused by First World War. You see, the First World War brought a great economic loss to Indians. And after the war, the economic condition of people in India was worst. It was also one of the cause of non-cooperation movement. Fourth point, Montagu-Chelmsford Act. The Montagu-Chelmsford Act 1919 could not satisfy the Congress, Indian National Congress, and the actual scheme of reforms which was given in this Reform Act was not fulfilled, and the demands of nationalists were not fulfilled. Next point is Rowlatt Act. The passing of Rowlatt Act, which was very, you can say, merciless, and Rowlatt Act caused Jallianwala massacre, the greatest tragedy in British India, Jallianwala massacre. Actually, in 1919, on 13th April, in Jallianwala, a garden in Punjab, people, they were, you know, protesting against British government because two leaders, Satyapal and Kichlew, they were arrested because in Rowlatt Act, there was a provision to arrest anybody without trial. So Satyapal and Kichlew were arrested, two nationalists, and to release them, there was a protest. However, you can say they were not allowed, and it was the cause of this movement. Next is Khilafat movement. Khilafat movement was very important movement in which Indian Muslims appealed British government not to, you can say, remove the caliph, spiritual leader in Turkey, Ottoman Empire. The Khilafat leaders were told by British that they should not accept anything more. That's why Indian Muslims were also against British. That's why it became one of the cause. Let's revisit the causes of non-cooperation movement. First point is, after First World War, Indians were harassed. Second point, home rule movement. Third point, economic distress caused by First World War. Fourth point, Montagu-Chelmsford reform. Fifth, Rowlatt Act. Sixth, Khilafat movement. These are the causes of non-cooperation movement. Now we'll discuss actually various facts related to non-cooperation movement. We know this non-cooperation movement was launched on 1st August 1920, and it was led by Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi after Jallianwala massacre. And the objective of non-cooperation movement was to resist British rule in India through non-violent means, that is Satyagraha. And in this movement, protesters refused to buy British goods and adopted the use of local handicrafts, and they pickpocket before liquor shops. Next is, the non-cooperation movement was a reaction to the oppressive policies of British Indian government, such as Rowlatt Act and Jallianwala massacre. I have already discussed. Indians who had participated in the Khilafat movement to restore the status of Caliph gave their support to this non-cooperation movement. The economic hardship to the common man, common Indians, also one of the causes I have discussed. And this non-cooperation movement was suspended by Gandhi all of a sudden on 5th February 1922. Because in Chauri Chaura, Chauri Chaura is a place in Uttar Pradesh, UP. In Chauri Chaura police station, there was a clash in between protesters who participated in non-cooperation movement and police, in which police killed 3 protesters, and as a result, police station was set on fire. Protesters just fired the police station, and 22 police personnel, they were killed, and as a result, Gandhi was shocked. Gandhi was shocked on this incident, and as a result, the non-cooperation movement was withdrawn because of this Chauri Chaura incident on 10th March 1922. And Gandhi was also imprisoned for 6 years for sedition charges, because Gandhi was solely responsible for non-cooperation movement, and Gandhi on the moral ground decided to suspend this non-cooperation movement because Gandhi had a mission to launch this non-cooperation movement on non-violent manner. However, this Chauri Chaura incident, violent incident, disheartened Gandhi, and Gandhi decided to suspend this. And as a result, Gandhi was also arrested for, and he was in jail for 6 years because Gandhi was spreading materials. In the eyes of British government, Gandhi was responsible for this. And Gandhi was arrested on 18th March 1922. Another fact is, Gandhi moved this non-cooperation movement resolution, or simply you can say non-cooperation movement, was held in Calcutta session of Indian National Congress in September 1920. Actually, it was a special session for launching non-cooperation movement, and Gandhi moved the resolution regarding non-cooperation movement. A non-cooperation movement was first nationwide mass movement. After that, civil disobedience movement will come in 1930. And in 1942, Quit India movement will come. However, this non-cooperation movement was first nationwide mass movement because all parties, common men, children, school children, men, women, everybody, every Indian participated. That's why it is regarded as first nationwide mass movement. And in this movement, Charkha and Khadi became symbol of Indian nationalism. Most of the time, questions asked, who was Viceroy during non-cooperation movement? Lord Chelmsford was Viceroy during non-cooperation movement. So these are the things you have to keep in mind while studying non-cooperation movement. Let's discuss the conclusion. The non-cooperation movement evoked an unprecedented enthusiasm, a spirit, a zeal throughout the country. Non-cooperation movement was first movement without weapon in the history of the world. Please remember, non-cooperation movement was the first movement without weapon in the history of the world. And it gave a new complexion to people's urge for freedom. And it is the beginning of new phase in Indian freedom movement. So you have to remember that non-cooperation movement was partly successful, partly it was highly successful, but certain things you have to remember, in certain cases it was not successful because it was suspended in between. However, it was a great success because in future India is getting independence because of this mass movement. According to R.C. Mazumdar, one historian, non-cooperation movement was an acid test for people. And this movement was successful in several cases. People became conscious of their political thought, political right. That means political consciousness now spreading across India. Second is, people lost their trust in British administration. Third, they became confident on self-reliance. That means boycotting of British goods and depending on handicrafts, own goods and services. That means now Indians are self-reliant. They do not depend upon anybody. Fourth point is, the government failed to create fear in their mind. These are the things you have to remember. So, thank you very much. Wish you happy learning. Thank you very much.